Guys, welcome to another episode of It's Your Kitchen. Well, first and always foremost, I would like to thank all of my followers, starting from Aruba, St. Martin, Bonaire, Curacao, Guyana, Suriname, Florida, Memphis, Tennessee, Arkansas, Ohio, Oregon, California, Connecticut, Delaware, Rhode Island, the Netherlands, England, my one Asian and my one Hindu, Mexico. All right. And guys, I would like to thank you all for joining me once again. Today, I would actually like to do a drink recipe. It is not from the island of Aruba. It's actually from the island of, you will get it from the West Indies, as in Jamaica, Trinidad, Guyana. You know, it is called sorrel. Yes, sorrel. I finally found some sorrel. I actually bought a plant and it's blooming some fresh sorrel. It is actually the flower of the hibiscus. Now, guys, don't mix it up with the hibiscus flower that everyone knows. It's a different type, okay? But it's very easy. We're gonna head over to the stovetop and we're gonna get on going. And again, I'm trying it out with you right now. So, so guys, stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. We're gonna head over to the stovetop and make some sorrel. All right, so stay tuned. Welcome back, guys. Here we are at the stovetop. What I have here, I have my trusty little pot here. Don't look at my, that's good cooking there. All right. In my pot, I have about 5.5 cups of water. All right. Again, it's 5.5 cups of water. Now here is, let's start from the easiest. I have 1 cup of sugar. And right here, this, the main star of this show is, I'm trying to get a nice one here for you, because it's dried sorrel. It's actually, it's like a flower, all right? You can see it right there. But this is the dried one. I have about 1.5 cups of dried sorrel. I have 1 ginger right here. Now the ginger, it all depends. Sorry for that. That's my little chihuahua, Imani. She's not getting the attention. She's in the living room. All right. And right next to it, the ginger, it all depends how little kick or spice that you like. So this would actually, if you grate this, it will come out to about maybe 2 tablespoons. It all depends on your taste buds. All right. And I have here about 11 cloves, and whole cloves, and 3 sticks of cinnamon. Now, this is why it's so easy, guys. This is gonna go all in there. The same for the 1 cup of sugar. Now, as it's, it will, I would say, come to a boil, leave it boil for about 5 to 8 minutes. And then you will just take off the flames and you just let it just settle and let it extract all of the flavor from the sorrel flour. All right. So guys, stay tuned. I prefer to cut up my ginger and I will do that. All right. And then we're going to place everything in a pot and let's make sorrel. All right, guys. Right, guys, welcome back. Now I just cut up, not rough chop, my ginger and I place it in. Oh, also very proud, this is homegrown ginger from my garden. If you don't have any, you can purchase it at the store. There is the ones at the store you will find. If you can get organic ginger, would be even better. It has much more flavoring in it. But if not, whatever you find, use it. All right. Okay, here we go. Again, very simple. The 1.5 cup of sorrel, 3 cinnamon sticks, and 11 whole cloves. And you just dump it all in. I have my flame on. See, everything is used. Oop, left one there. Come on, you're going to get in there as well. There you go. All right, I have my flame on a medium, and I'm just gonna let it come to a boil. Just gonna add in now the 1 cup of sugar. The reason why I'm adding in the sugar right now is because the sorrel flour by itself, it is very bitter, very, very bitter. And with that ginger as well in the cloves, so that 1 cup of sugar is gonna start a little of the sweetened process. But as you're ready to actually drink this sorrel, you can actually add more sugar, basically according to your taste buds. All right, get my little spoon right here. Just give it a quick little stir. All right. So guys, I'm gonna let this go for about 8 to 10 minutes. And then I'm gonna come with a white spoon and actually show you what happened to this water. All right. It's actually doing it already, but I'm gonna come with a white spoon so you would see the color of the water. All right, guys, so don't go anywhere. Stay tuned, I'll be right back in the next 5 to 8 minutes. Come back, guys. So it has been about 5 minutes, and I got the white spoon here because I want you to see the color. Look at that. Look at that. Oops, no, not the flour, but look at the liquid. It has turned to this really dark auburn. No, not auburn, that's a different thing. It has turned into a nice dark red, almost burgundy color. And the smell of the cloves and the cinnamon and definitely that ginger, wow, it smells really, really good. As you can see, even the cinnamon has gotten a little tint of that color. All right, we're doing good. Again, as I said, I'm trying this out in front of you right now. No editing like those professional cooking shows. Hey, we're not professional here. We're learning as we go. So I'm learning with you. All right. Now, the best thing how to drink this is basically once it's completely cooled, completely, the best way to serve this is on ice. It is actually a Christmas, a holiday drink. I have seen some to preserve this. I would not recommend it because it might not last that long. To preserve it a little longer, they place it in a complete sterile clean bottle and pour in some brown rice to keep it fermenting. But this is not going to last that long. All right. So what I'm going to do now, just want you to see it again. Look at that color. You could see that color. So it has extracted a lot of the color and flavoring from the sorrel flour. All right, so I'm gonna turn off my stove now and just let this, sit for a while so it can take, and give it a quick little roaring boil there. No. So I'm gonna just let this sit and extract as much of the leftover flavor and coloring from the flour. All right. If you hear that popping just now in the background, it's close to the New Year. So, you know, the kids has bought their fireworks and they're popping them. So anyway, see you in another 5 to 10 minutes until this has been completely cooled and we're going to strain this out. All right. So stay tuned. Welcome back, guys. All right, I have let it cool down a good bit. As you can see, I've strained it, and this is the result. So this cannot be used anymore. These are all like the cinnamon stick. As you can see, the cinnamon got that, also the color on it. This cannot be used anymore. These are the sorrel flowers or the hibiscus flowers. Again, it's not the hibiscus what you know of, okay? All right, but this, I use the dried sorrel flowers. And in my bowl right here, I have drained, and this is all of the liquid. All right. So as it boils, keep in mind you're boiling liquid. It's going. Some of the liquid will evaporate. So most likely it's not 5.5 cups anymore. It may be 4.5, maybe. But also, if you like, you can, once this is completely cooled down, I'll place it in a glass water jug and place it into the refrigerator so it can chill. And then I will do a little taste to see if it's just how I know how sorrel should taste. But everyone has a different recipe. As I said, guys, I'm learning this with you right now, right here. So this is my first time making it. All right, so I will give it a taste and then see if it needs any more sweetener, as in more sugar, or just as is. All right, I give it a quick little taste test. It was warm still, and I don't think I'm going to be adding any sugar. That 1 cup of sugar was perfect enough. I wanted it for myself a little bit more with a little kick of the ginger. I can taste the ginger, so maybe the next time I try this out, instead of adding 1 cup of sugar, I will add in maybe 1/2 cup of sugar. But right now, as how it tastes when I did a little quick taste test, it's good for me. All right, guys? So I'm going to let this cool down some more, place it in a glass water jug, place it in the refrigerator, and then I'm going to give it a nice taste with on ice and have a great glass of sorrel. So don't go anywhere, guys. Stay with me. Guys, well, I let it completely cool down. I'm going to show you. I have my glass with ice ready, and I place it in my jug, and as you can see, it's a very dark, if you can see that, it's a very dark, almost like a burgundy color. Now, if you do have or know anyone that has also the fresh sorrel, actually when you use the fresh sorrel, it comes out a little more lighter than this. Since this has been dried, a lot of the color, everything was dried in there and just like really stayed there. If you don't want it this dark, if you're going to use the dried sorrel, maybe you can use 1/2 cup or maybe 1 cup of the dried sorrel. All right. So I'm going to pour some in here, just right in here. Again, always great over... Place this right here. Yes. Over some water. Again, this is used a lot. Really not that much here on the island of Aruba. Oops, forgot my shades. Sorry about that. Was outside. And actually, this is more from the West Indies islands. Also like Jamaica, Trinidad, Guyana also, Barbados. They would tend to have this drink for the Christmas holidays. You know, it's part of their staple drinks. All right. Here we go. Gonna give this a shot. Whoa. I made sorrel. Wow. As I said, I would like it a little bit with a kick of the ginger. So either I will put in some more ginger while it's doing the boiling treatment on the stovetop. But this is good. This is real good. Oh, for one of my, the person that actually encouraged me in starting up this cooking segment, lives in Rhode Island. Hey, Karen. She's a fan of the drink Marby. Karen, this is for you. Try this. Dried sorrel. I most likely think that you can find this, all this product on Amazon, and also and if you have a West Indian supermarket, especially in the US or England, the UK, they definitely should have the dried sorrel. Gotta take a next sip. Oh, wow. And if you want to really give it a good buzz, you can put some alcohol in that. All right. But if you're going to give it to kids, no alcohol. Guys, oh, wow. I'm going to definitely going to be buying some more of this and be more making more of this. All right. Guys, before I close off, I would love to say thank you. And also, don't forget, hit the notification bell and the subscribe button so every time I come up with a new recipe or drink, you'll be the first to know. All right, guys. So once again, to all of my followers, thank you so much from the islands of Aruba, Bonaire, Curacao, St. Martin, Guyana, Suriname, Florida, Memphis, Tennessee, Arkansas, Ohio, California, Oregon, Delaware, Connecticut, Mexico, my one Asian and my one Hindu follower, Rhode Island. I said Connecticut, if not Connecticut. All right. Also, England and the Netherlands. If I did forget, never fear. You're always here with me, and we're always cooking in the kitchen together. All right, guys. Always try out something new. We're not chefs here, okay? We're cooking, experimenting with drinks, and learning as we go. So, and always, always, always remember, it's your kitchen. All right, guys? Enjoy. And if I don't see or not see, well, you know. Guys, I do wish you a great holiday, a great Christmas, a beautiful and safe and brighter 2022 that's ahead of us. Hoping that it will bring us relief from what we've been going through from since 2020. All right, guys? So always remember, never give up hope. The light is at the end of that tunnel. We're going to make it. All right? It's your kitchen and happy holidays. All right, guys. I'm going to drink this whole thing. Guys, bye. Until next time.